Dumbass. Noun. Someone who takes their daily driver drifting. Hello and welcome back to Speed Freak Garage, home of PowerSports on YouTube. We went drifting on Friday, as many of you may have seen, and apparently soft orange cones aren't so soft. Or I hit something on the highway on the way back without realizing it, but I'm pretty sure a cone did that. So, I'm done drifting. I'm fucking done. No more drifting. Too much damage to the vehicle. So, and my studs are all effed up. That'll be a different video, but we're gonna pull out the fender liner since it's all screwed up anyway. And we're gonna try and fix this bumper. We're gonna do a heat gun first. If that doesn't work, we'll have to get some boiling water and some towels and try not to burn ourselves while doing it that way. So, yeah, let's get started. So, the fender liner is one big piece that unfortunately isn't the easiest to remove. So we're gonna try and maybe just bend it out of the way. It's a pretty soft plastic. So you gotta pop your pop tabs. And unfortunately, they're also soft plastic, so I'll probably have to order some new ones off Amazon. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to order new ones off Amazon. Because they're essentially designed to break. They're not made to be, you know, multi-use. I mean, they just aren't. So, but luckily, instead of going to the dealership and paying a dollar each, you can get on Amazon and get packs and packs and packs for almost nothing. So, and I probably already have some somewhere. And you'll notice I'm not sitting down. It's because there's you can't see them. They're really tiny, but there are ants everywhere. I don't know what the fuck they're doing, because there's no food around here that I know of, but oh boy. Yeah, this isn't gonna be fun. Doesn't help that, you know, it's been underneath the car this whole time, so it's full of sand and dirt and all kinds of other shit that doesn't want to cooperate. And then you'll have like these little ones. Ooh. Yeah. Sometimes you'll have ones that require a Phillips, and it's so lame because, well, like for instance, this one just immediately stripped out. Unbelievable. Damn it. I'm just gonna pull it out. Try not to screw up my side marker on the way. Okay. Anyway, so try to pull this one out because it's fucked up. Fuck, it really doesn't want to come out. It's like it's attached to the turn signal or the side marker, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I don't care. Yeah, that's lame. Wait. Is that a part of the side marker, or was it just really good in there? Oh, fucking hell, come on. Push it through the back. Man, this just never goes to plan, like... See if I can get this to come out the back. Got it. Okay. So, got a ton more of these bastards to deal with. Whoops. Gonna end up replacing all of them, I think, just to be safe. We got that, and there's the piece underneath is attached. I have to get out. There's one. Got probably should take that one out too, and I should be able to just bend this whole thing out of the way. Tab under here. Okay. And then those look all right. There's one here. And then this one's screwed in. Luckily it didn't rip out like the other side did. I already had to drill holes in the other fender liner and stitch it back up. Wasn't really enough of a job to make a video out of. And I did it really quick because I needed to drive the next day. And that was before I noticed this giant hole in my bumper. And some jackass over-tightened this and it's gonna probably break off. You gotta be kidding me. Fucking stupid Subaru. Fuck. Why would you do that? Fucking assholes. I'm just gonna have to fucking break it off. Fucking assholes.
Oh yeah, let's put, you know, 100 foot-pounds on a piece of plastic.
Well, there goes that. I'll have to stitch that back together. God, fucking jerks. See if I can even there's got to be a way to hold the damn thing in place. Unbelievable. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. Fuck. Okay. Let's do it the hard way. Fucking ripping it off. Wonderful. Unbelievable. Fucking cheap shit. Okay, so we got this part freed. Piece of my fender's kind of... So we need to get this out of the way without completely fucking ruining it. Okay, and that's... That's good enough to get a hand in there. Probably didn't have to take all of this down, actually. Probably could have just took this part down and gotten a hand up. I'm intelligent. Whatever, it was all fucked up anyway. I need to fix it. I guarantee you if I go and type in mudguard assembly FLH, it'll be like $100-something. Not that it matters, because the part that it attaches to on the bumper's gone now. Ooh, that wire's kind of close to that metal. So, now we gotta wait for my friend to get here, who knows way more about this than I do. Because I do not want to have to get a new bumper. It's really expensive. We'll be back in a sec.
God damn, you did fuck that thing all up, didn't you? Son of a bitch.
Alright, so we're back. We got our master mechanic, Anthony, and our secondary master mechanic, Brandon. Don't mind his Honda shirt. It's okay. He's allowed to be around Toyota. But so Brandon has experience with this. He's gonna help out, or I'm gonna let him take over and see if we can get this thing popped out.
Alrighty. So basically you'll need a heat gun, and you'll need some sort of hard, dense object to press from the backside.
Like a big wooden stick.
Like a big wooden stick. And basically you want to turn on the low setting of your heat gun, so that way you make sure you don't damage your bumper at all or the paint. And you want to evenly heat up the entire dent or flaw, and then also a little bit around it.
And there are some people who suggest using a towel and pouring boiling water on it, but we have a friend who was in the hospital for burns from boiling water, so we're not going to do that. But if you want to go to the hospital, you're welcome to give it a try.
Well, just don't be a fucking idiot.
It usually doesn't.
But polyurethane is basically, the way it's designed and the way the material properties work is when it gets to a certain temperature, it will try to return to its molding state. So the state when it was injection molded, which is why you can fold them up and ship them overseas, unfold them, and as Brandon said, lay them out in the sun and they go back to the way they were. The only thing here that we can't fix is the paint. I think the dent will come out, it's just the paint's done for.
Rocket bunny.
No.
Rocket bunny.
No. No, it's overused. Oh, there's a kit called Rally Backer that's pretty fucking sweet. And then the Varus kit, but that's, you know, $8,000. Fuck that.
Yeah.
It's a couple paychecks.
Yeah. It's like months and months of ramen noodles and
race car now.
Right. Nice. Nice. Look at that. Look at that. I'm glad I know this guy.
I'm useful for some things.
He's really good with wooden sticks.
Good with your sticks if you need stick work.
Damn, that gun's hot though, man. Holy shit, that's a nice one.
Yeah. And this is on the low setting. Like I said,
that's a low setting?
Yeah.
It's fucking burning my hand from here. Holy shit, look at that. Look at that pro shit. And all I have to do is come back with a sponge and scrub off that.
Yep.
And ain't nobody gonna notice unless they get too close. Dude, you're awesome. Fuck yeah, dude.
That's right.
Woo!
World sport. Yeah, they're pretty easy. Like you were saying though, they naturally want to pop to the original shape, so.
Yeah, luckily, if this had been fiberglass, it would have been exploded. So yeah. I actually found some fender clips. You can get these. Okay, so it's $1 a clip at the dealership. Fucking dealership asshole.
Hey.
And hey. Or you can go on Amazon and get 15 for $1. So I got just some assorted sizes, and we're gonna see which ones work. try and get this back together. Then we're gonna drill some holes and zip tie some stitches in there. So the first thing,
drift stitches,
yeah. Yeah, exactly. Is get it back inside.
Yeah, I didn't think that.
Go ahead.
I didn't think that.
Cool. I was flipping shit, honestly. Like, when I came out to work Monday morning and I saw that, I was like, who the fuck hit my car with a baseball bat? Like, the first thing that came to my mind was somebody in town was pissed off because I was drifting around and they fucking bashed my bumper in.
James.
That was like my first thought.
No one gives a shit. It's all in your mind.
So on
You're
the,
just a bad driver.
On the internet, hey. On the way here, some dude in like an S10, like a factory stock S10, drove by me and was like this. I guess he was referring to my penis.
Oh, jeez.
I thought there was like, a cop behind me, so I didn't like ride him too hard, but.
It's like, hold on, man. You drive a truck. Like, what are you trying to say?
Hey. Don't knock them shitty little trucks, okay? They get decent mileage. But they kind of are pieces of shit.
Uh-oh. I might have to order clips after all.
Fucking hell.
Nope, I've got it. I'm a genius. It's the little pretend screwdriver ones.
What's the matter? You're not putting... Are they zinkies?
No, I'm not putting those on my car.
Why aren't you putting these on your car?
I'm just going to wait for him to bring back my wheels.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, I'm sure about that.
I think we should put them on. I think they look really good.
It's... Aside from the fact that my studs are fucked up already...
Sounds like operator valve problems there.
Fuck you. Hey, the forged steel ones are here. I just don't have the dye to clean my studs up yet.
Dude, just use an impact.
You should go work at a dealership.
God damn.
Uh-oh. Yeah, that's the right one. These aren't exactly flush mount like the originals, but they're... What are you doing over there?
I'm just imagining.
Are you molesting my girl?
No, I'm just imagining how much better your car would look with these wheels on it.
I just don't... I've never been a fan of, like, the flashy colors.
Those aren't flashy, James. Come on.
Gold?
Get in the 21st century.
Try and tell me gold's not flashy.
Gold! You, it's gold! Aren't these lighter than your wheels, though?
No way. My wheels are only 15 pounds.
I don't know what those weigh.
There's no way they're lighter. No way.
Those are some Craigslist specials, but that just poor kid didn't know what the fuck he had.
Yeah, he got a good deal on those, that's for sure.
Like a...
That's why you always...
A cammed Lancer that's actually a higher displacement because of it.
I put a cam in it, so it's now a 2.4 liter instead of a 2 liter. Fucking idiot.
Rip.
And at that moment, we knew it was Daddy's money.
Damn. Shit.
Low-key, this kid's gonna watch this video and be like, that was me.
Yes. And if you watch this fucking video, I wanna see you again, motherfucker.
Jeez.
Granny shifting my fucking... It's on 27 pounds of boost.
What?
My dad paid for it.
Whoa, this is coming from the guy.
With the white Lancer.
With, never mind.
1.8 pounds. Oh, thank you very much. All right.
Using it for the purpose of
exactly. I just used that Jeep. How that Jeep was designed to be used.
You could have edited that out.
Absolutely.
It's too late now.
But James doesn't fucking edit anything.
No, I'm too lazy for that shit.
Up there raw.
I'm too lazy for that shit.
2 hours putting this taking this transmission apart.
No editing.
Outro, send it on its way.
Yeah.
But I gotta do anything.
Yeah, I spent
shit.
Enough time
send
fucking
it.
Filming it.
I'm gonna send it.
That's funny.
I cannot get this one in.
Story of your life.
Yeah, you're right. No, but for real, this one's not playing nice.
Smack it around a little
shit.
Bit.
What do you call your daddy? So now that I beat a 1,000, are you never going to race me again on your 600 or not?
I can't believe you beat that guy. Like, I do have to agree that is kind of crazy.
He out mile an hour and beat by like 10 mile an hour, but you know what?
So he was coming up, he just never made it.
He 60 more feet and he would have had me, but son of a bitch, I still beat a 1,000.
You're supposed to be like Street Outlaws. Yeah, bang the light. Never saw him.
No. Fuck, I looked around. I could hear him coming. It was just the biggest thing. I just heard, wah!
Yes, he could have been not. Yeah, he could have been scared to death of the thing, too.
He had a fucking long arm on it, and still.
A what? A long swing arm?
Still couldn't get me.
I don't like those, man. Those are like.
They look fucking ugly, but when you're drag racing, that's all you got, then you keep fucking flipping over backwards.
That's true.
You can actually buy kits for my car that actually lengthen your wheelbase.
What?
Yeah, they take the they take like the rear wheels and actually move them back into function. So you get more longer wheelbase, more stability.
Yeah, because you need them when they're fucking matchbox.
Basically.
That's how my car is though. That's why you hardly ever see my car, people drift my car, only because it's such short wheelbase. Fucking awful.
Short wheelbase is good for autocross though.
Not for drifting.
No, not at all.
You drive a Mustang, why are you worrying about corners?
Y'all, all it has to do is rain and you're off on the the road.
I fucking worry about corners because I'll die every time I run into one.
Maybe you should try turning.
Maybe I should try a tire with sidewall. So those have sidewall, but they're so damn soft because, you know, bias plies are super... are super supportive on the sides.
That's right. That's what you want. That's what you need.
But I need. That's what I need to go in straight line.
Oh, this is so bad.
Oh shit! We're breaking out the drill. Drift stitches time.
Ooh, look at that pro kit.
Yeah, I got that on Amazon for like $5.
I was gonna say, was that an Amazon pro kit?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
The hardest part is just holding the shit still so it'll drill. And I have to do one up here.
No, but I'm
just realized I was like an inch away from my washer fluid bottle.
Ah, you don't need
that would have been fucking intelligent.
Dude, mine don't work.
Mine does.
Mine's from fucking 1989, so you know. I have an excuse at least.
That's from 99.
Oh, that was my wave. Yeah, I got 10 years on
the
good.
Dude, the first time I scrape up on a curve, this zip tie is a goner.
Bah!
Here, where's my little cutters?
Cute little dog now cutters.
Dude, they work good though.
Hey, dude. That's legit. What I thought about my trans pan, and it's still on there, so. Actually, it's my oil pan more than anything else.
Yeah, dude, your fucking oil pan. I can't believe it's fucking. Ooh, it's so low.
They're nasty low.
They're nasty low. Oil pan almost touches the ground, but still needs a cowl hood.
Yeah, if you LS swap this car, you have to lower the steering rack. You gotta cut some shit.
You have to lower the whole, like, game member, because them motors are just... yours are so small.
Well, I think that's it. That was much smoother than I expected.
It's because you had Master Mechanic and...
Master Mechanic, too.
Master Mechanic.
He's good at working on bodies.
I get a lot of practice.
Oh,
fuck. No, you can't say that. And with that, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you for the next video repairing my fucked up studs.
See ya.